The good thing is that once you understand how hashtags work and set up a system, hashtags will be a piece of cake. Hey guys, what's up? Sam here. Welcome back to my channel where I talk about social media for creators and entrepreneurs. I'm really excited about today's video because we're going to be talking about one of my favorite topics, hashtags. I get so many questions asking me about hashtags.
How many should I add? Should I add them to the caption or in the comments? What's the best strategy for choosing hashtags?
And so on. That is why I decided to film this video and reveal my winning strategy that is designed to get maximum exposure, which will help you grow your account. If you're trying to grow on Instagram, you have to master hashtags. There's just no other way around it. Creating posts takes a lot of time and effort, and that's why you have to make sure that as many people as possible see it, click on your profile, maybe follow you, or even become your customer. It's one of a few rare opportunities for new people to discover your content, and that's why you have to master the art of hashtagging to perfection. You want to attract the right people who are going to become a part of your community and are actually interested in your content, so picking the right hashtags is key. So using random hashtags like love and like for like will attract random people to your account, and that's not what you want. Sure, it might boost your numbers a little bit, but these people won't engage with you, let alone become your customers. So there's no point in doing that. I've been working with dozens of accounts and I can confirm that the right strategy really makes a difference. So today I want to show you my recipe that really works and that I use for my clients. So if you want to master hashtags and create a bulletproof strategy that will maximize your exposure and get your content found more often, which will then get you more followers and sales, then keep on watching. All right, so first things first, there's a limit of 30 hashtags under each post, but how many should you actually use? There has been so much back and forth about this. Some people say it's spammy to use all 30, but I would say use as many as you want, as long as they're relevant. That's the key here. Every hashtag is a chance to get found, so the more hashtags you have, the more exposure you'll get. I usually try to do as many as possible, but at least 20. So if you click on a hashtag, you'll see there are two ways you can get discovered through hashtags, and that is through latest posts and top posts. Latest posts are arranged in chronological order, so the latest posts will appear on the top and they will start moving down as the post with the same hashtags appear on the top. How long your post will be here on top depends on the frequency of posts being posted with this hashtag or how popular it is. So some hashtags are more popular, the bigger ones, and some hashtags are smaller, less popular ones. The other category you'll see when you click on a hashtag is top posts. Here you'll see the popular posts on this hashtag, which are determined by the algorithm. But the most important determining factor for getting on top posts is engagement. Of course, if the algorithm sees that people like the content, they will try to show it to more people. So this is the goal. You want to rank in top posts category for less popular, more niche hashtags that are super targeted. Once you start gaining traction and engagement from there, you'll hopefully start ranking on the medium-sized hashtags. Then you'll get even more engagement from there, and lastly, hopefully land on top posts for the larger hashtags. That's the goal. So to try and achieve this snowball effect, you're going to have to use a mix of smaller, less popular, medium, and large hashtags. If the snowball effect doesn't happen, it's still okay because top performing posts can stay on those top placements for weeks or even months on the smaller hashtags, which can give you a lot of exposure. But how can you tell which hashtags are small, medium, or large? You can check the size of the hashtag by going to the magnifying glass and start typing a hashtag in the search. This number will tell you how many posts are associated with your hashtag. So the wider the term, the more posts it will have. So just start searching for it and check out the number listed under the hashtag. So a wider term like hashtag love will have an insane amount of posts. But if you type in a more narrow hashtag, like for example, Instagram strategy, it will have way less posts. So let's look at hashtags as three different buckets: small, medium, and large. I would say the small hashtags have from a few thousand to around 50,000 posts. Medium hashtags fall in the kind of high tens of thousands into that mid hundreds of thousand range. And the large ones are up to 1 million. Anything over 1 million, basically becomes irrelevant because it's just too saturated. So you want to pick hashtags from each of these three buckets and create a mix. If your account is smaller, choose most hashtags from the smaller bucket, some from the medium one and a few from a large one. But if you have a larger following, choose less smaller ones, but more medium and big ones. This will have a better chance to compete for the top spots. Also, make sure your hashtags are relevant and really describe what's on the photo. If you just add random hashtags, people that are going through hashtags are not going to engage with you because your post is not what they're looking for, which will let the algorithm know not to push your post to top posts, which will do more damage than good. So how do you pick your hashtags? Sometimes it's really hard to think of 20 or 30 hashtags off the top of their head. So most people can just think of 5 or 10 and don't know which other ones to add. So that's why it's really important to do hashtag research beforehand and have a few hashtag sets of 20 or 30 hashtags already prepared. They have to be a mix of a few different categories. The things that are on your photo, your industry hashtags, then location hashtags if it makes sense for your business, then hashtags for each of your content types, and so on. You want it to be something really specific to your industry or the content you're going to post because you want to attract the right audience. Think about which hashtags would your potential customers go to. When your hashtag sets are created, just save them to your notes. And every time you want to post, just go to your notes, see which set fits your post best. Change it a little bit by deleting hashtags that are not relevant for that post, or even add a few new ones. Copy-paste them to Instagram and post. If you're interested in seeing how I do hashtag research, then let me know in the comments below and I'll create a video on that. All right, so now that we've chosen our hashtags, we have to decide where we're going to post them, either in the caption or in the comments. That is probably the most frequently asked question I get, so let me finally explain it in detail. While both options work, posting in the caption is more efficient. Why? Because the second you post your post with hashtags in the caption, your post will appear in the recent post category of your hashtags. If you decide to post hashtags in the comments, you will lose that first few seconds between posting and adding your hashtags in the comments, and your post will already be buried under a huge pile of other posts, especially in the popular hashtags. So, for example, your post will not appear at the top of recent posts in your hashtag, but in a second, third, or fourth row, or even further down if the hashtag is really popular. So you wouldn't get that initial burst of activity. On the other hand, some people think it just doesn't look good and that it looks a little bit spammy, so they would rather just post in the comments anyway. So what I do is I post them in the caption, but put a few dots after the caption to hide it. So I don't think it looks that bad and I would definitely recommend you do that, but it's completely your choice. All right, so now you've done all the work and you want to see if your hashtags are working. So the best way to do that is to go back to the post and click View Insights. Click it and scroll down to where Instagram breaks down the impressions and reach. This will let you know where your impressions came from and how many came from your hashtags. I would take a few minutes each month to write down these numbers and analyze which posts are getting the most reach from the hashtags and just try and figure out what works best. This is really cool because you can compare hashtag sets on different posts and see which one worked best, which can help you in the future. All right, guys, I hope I made things a little bit more clear for you. If you have any questions, please let me know down in the comments. And also let me know if you would like to see the video on how I do hashtag research. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Ryan Little.